bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make a boast in the Lord. And I want you to hear thereof and declare, oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt his name together. Good morning, my brothers and sisters. We want to wish a happy Mother's Day for all the mothers who are in the hearing of my voice. And we pray that all of you do all you can to make that special mother in your life very happy. If you're lacking any, mama has already gone to be with the Lord. Just speak to somebody and make them happy today. Make sure they have a good day. Don't sit around feeling sad, but make this a glorious day in the life of the saints. We praise God for another privilege to come together and worship, and we solicit your prayers for these worship services. We pray that God's Spirit will move in a special, special way. Our ministers of music and musicians will lead us now in praise period. We are so blessed to have again the great Sister Crystal Jordan.
Thank you. found in the book of Romans, the fifth chapter. The book of Romans, chapter 5. We will begin reading at verse 18. Romans chapter 5, beginning at verse 18.
birthday song. And it's for the million things she gave me. Oh, as I'm in that, she's growing old. Tears for the tears she shed to save me. And checks for her heart, the purest gold. Tears for her eyes.
thank God for the mixing and rendition. I'm thankful again for music staff, Sister Sandra Tucker. Yeah, Al Green on drums. And blessed to have leading us today, Sister Crystal. Those who stay in, I do understand. I have no problem with that. But I will be here. If you want to meet me here, you're welcome to do so on next Sunday. A sermon today coming from Romans chapter 5. Romans chapter 5. Sometimes it's good to read scripture for a long time. Starting in verse 18, chapter 5, Romans. Therefore, as by the offense of one judgment came upon all men to condemnation, even so by the righteousness of one, free gift came upon all men unto justification of life. Excuse me. For as by one man disobedience, many were made sinners, so by the obedience of one shall many be made righteous. For the law entered that the offense might abound, but where sin abounded, grace did much more. Somebody say much more. Much more about that as sin had reigned unto death, even so might grace reign through righteousness unto eternal life by Jesus Christ our Lord. Today I want to labor for a few minutes from the subject Christians conquering criminal connections. Christians conquering criminal connections. This is Mother's Day. What that has to do with Mother's Day, preacher? We're talking about heredity. When you talk about heredity, you have to also include inheritance. Heredity makes possible our inheritance. today with this matter of our relationship, our connection to God, and our connection to mama and daddy, and our connection to Adam. Let me start by talking about the real relationship that is true. Man has a real and natural connection, relationship with Adam. Man has a real and natural relationship with God. You want to talk about who you had today? We're all connected. This matter of race relations is really nonsense, because the truth of the matter is that we all are part of the same race. We're all a part of the human race. That when you start trying to trace your roots, most of the time you're guilty of stopping too soon.
Amen.
Because if you keep digging, you're going to be back in the Garden of Eden. And a fella called Adam.
Amen.
In other words, all of us got the same great granddaddy.
Yeah.
And his name is Adam. Do I have a witness here? I'm talking about a natural relationship that we are all related. We are not just cousins. I'm talking about blood relatives. We have a blood relationship with Adam. That you can trace your roots back to him. Well, if you look at the matter, Adam really is not the first one. The relationship really started with the Y'all better hear me today. That life didn't start with Adam. Life started with God.
Yeah.
It was God who breathed into man the breath of life.
Mm-hmm.
And man became a living nephesh, a living soul, a living being. Oh, I wish I had somebody to pray with.
Yeah.
That all of us have a natural relationship with God. Well, man awakes to find that in his condition, he has something he was born with.
Yeah.
This matter of lust and greed and passion and evil are all part of us naturally.
Amen.
Ain't no sense you rolling your eyes at me. Ain't no sense you trying to pretend, you know, heaven. That's just a part. You're born with that.
Amen.
You wake up with that. That's a part of your nature. That's a part of who you are. You have inherited the sin nature. And you have inherited that nature from Adam.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, that ain't fair. Why I got to make up for his sin? And I always say, don't be hating on Adam. But if you were in Eve's place and you were in Adam's place, you would do the identical same thing they did.
Yeah, yeah.
Y'all look at me like I'm crazy. You don't need Adam. How many of you have ever committed a sin? I had a witness here.
Amen.
That is, well, just like you messed up then, you would have messed up then.
Yeah.
That what Satan did, Satan appealed to his greed. Satan appealed to his love. Satan appealed to his selfishness. And consequently, Adam chose to go Satan's way because Satan made him believe he would be on the same level with God.
Yeah, yeah.
I wish I had a witness here. This matter of us trying to overdo or outdo somebody else is something that's a part of our innate nature. So then I have to understand that there are laws, and that God's laws are made with some consequences to our disobeying them. Yeah, you can obey the law and you can disobey the law. Adam messed up, and when Adam messed up, Satan said, well, you broke the law. What law? He said, don't eat, and he ate. When he said don't eat, that's the law. When he broke the law, he has to then pay the consequences of the law.
Yeah, yeah.
Right. Oh, y'all don't hear me. Well, my brothers and sisters, that Adam broke it is the same reason a whole lot of people write it. Race today, but what you need to understand, all laws are not the same.
Mm-hmm.
All laws, hold on, no. See, it depends on who makes the laws. Mm-hmm.
Right.
See, in our country, we have what you call, it's supposed to be a democracy. And in ours, I said, supposed to be. they claim that we have a balance.
plan.
Come on, here, somebody. That,
yeah, yeah.
That the legislators can't just make laws arbitrarily. They have to make sure they agree with the executive branch.
Right.
The president can't just make laws arbitrarily.
Right.
He has to make sure it agrees with the judicial branch. The courts
right.
can't just make laws from the judge seat. They have to balance between the three.
Right. Right.
I wish I had a witness
right.
here. But I wonder what happened. What happened with this Colbert? We don't have no balance.
Hmm. Right. Say it.
I wish I had a witness
right.
here. They had an executive order. We had a little county judge decide he's gonna take over.
Right.
And he had out his little executive law. People try to act like that's gospel.
Yeah.
Which I had a witness here.
Right.
They're handsome. I like Odell. They're a good sports writer.
ABC.
I like Odell. He had a way of always coming out with a different view. They're a different
man.
You know? Dale came out talking about the lady. Y'all heard about the lady who had a problem with her. Beauty salon. Talked about that. Everything he said about it was true.
Yeah, Lord.
But I disagreed with his conclusion. I liked it. But sometimes we don't agree. You can't back somebody who don't agree with them all the time.
Huh.
But Dale, let me tell you what Dale said. I like Dale. Dale said, the lady, I don't see why I was upset that the judge put her in jail.
Right.
The lady was put in jail because she broke the law.
Yeah.
And she is not above the law.
Right.
Y'all better hear me today.
Right.
She was in jail because she broke the law.
Mm-hmm.
And the judge decided he was going to give us some fines and put her in jail.
Right.
I wish I had the witness here.
Right.
Dale, that's what really made some folk mad. Dale said, now if she had been somebody who lived in South Dallas.
And
you folks who don't live in Dallas, who listen to my voice, that's where the brothers and sisters live. Black folk, colored folk.
Yeah.
And he said, if she had been black, we wouldn't even have a discussion. Nobody ain't gonna be upset because she got put in jail.
Right.
Nobody ain't gonna be raising no money, $500,000.
Yeah.
I wish I had a witness here. Nobody gonna have a problem with nothing that transpired. She would still be in jail. Come on, hear somebody.
Say it.
And she is in jail before she broke the law.
Yeah.
As I said, well, everything he said is true.
Amen.
That's the way it would happen. You might not like truth, but truth is true.
Right.
And then, man, why do you disagree with it? I disagree with it because he said the lady broke the law. She did. But Dale's mistake is a mistake a lot of y'all made. You assume all laws are on the same level.
Right. Amen.
Oh, yeah, I said something. You be mad at me for it's open. You see, everybody make a law, don't make the law right.
Because
when Bill County judge start making laws arbitrarily, that don't make it a law.
That's right.
It has to pass through a certain cycle for all of us to have to abide by. Even the president can't have a letter. You can't just arbitrarily say something, make it a law.
Right.
Because it has to pass through a certain procedure. Y'all better hear me. So because the judge, and you see that's what happens, you can put small people in big positions and they forget who they are. Oh, I wish I had a witness here. So this judge, he decides he's gonna judge her. And he had the audacity to say, you were selfish because you left your house and put everybody else in danger. The lady countered with, sir, and she was respectful. I respectfully disagree. You said I was selfish, but I was not selfish. I went, opened up my shop so I could feed my hungry children. Oh, yeah, you got quiet right there. I was just trying to feed my children. And I don't think that's selfish, trying to feed your children.
Right.
Now, let me say something that's going to be real controversial. Some of y'all going to have a problem with it. Y'all need to stop all this mess telling everybody you ought to stay home. That's what's best for you. Number one, you don't know what's best for anybody. Because, again, we're dealing with a different kind of problem here. We're dealing with something that we can't define. You see how these little children start dying from a totally different disease?
Right.
That's what's really going on.
Right.
But look at what happened. This matter of y'all telling folk to stay home. Let me tell you something. Everybody who's crying to stay home are people who are economically able to stay home. He got quiet, didn't he?
Well,
see, the problem with telling everybody to stay home is everybody can't stay home. Come on, hear somebody. Because see, if you stay home, eventually you're going to die of starvation. Y'all got small memories, but the president said, y'all president, he got up and said, in March, you're going to get a check. It's going to help you. It ain't going to be no longer than 1 or 2 weeks. That was in March. Come on here, somebody. I checked my mailbox yesterday. I ain't got that something yet.
Right.
You better hear me today. You folks talking about, you're going to get your check when you get unemployed. You can apply for unemployment. Come on here, somebody.
Say it.
Oh, yeah. You ain't got to say it, man. I'm Christian. I know I'm home. You know how many people that are unemployed that can't even reach the unemployment office?
Yeah.
But see, y'all don't care about that. Because see, we ain't going to announce that far. We're going to smother all of that.
Right.
And we're going to keep that y'all staying home. So you can, it's hard to survive when you're hungry.
Yeah.
Then you're going to send them in a line to get some food. And you're going to tell us how many folks making food. I got a problem with y'all putting Band-Aids on surgery.
Right.
So you don't have open heart surgery, put a band-aid on it and say, right. All right. Y'all better hear me.
Right.
That if you're gonna open up a problem, you need to understand the consequences of the problem.
Right.
The little boxes of food you hand out ain't gonna feed nobody.
Right.
Come on here, somebody.
Right.
If you got $1,000, how long $1,000 gonna last? Those people been without a job the rest of March, April, and here we are into May. You would have had no food, no money. How long do you think that's going to last?
Say it.
Landlords kicking people out of their house. We right. Part of the law. They can't kick you out. But our folks, they ain't got nowhere to stay.
Right.
And see, you get on TV talking all this mess because you live in your little closed world. You see, we got a problem getting able to identify with people who are less fortunate than us.
Yeah.
Y'all better hear me today. I ain't talking about me. I got some food in the freezer. And my daddy taught me how to live on beans and rice.
All right now.
But you see, everybody don't have it that way.
Right.
I know how it is to be hungry. I know how it is to be poor. Not because my daddy always had some food on my table. But see, hungry for me was when you fast 2 days.
Right.
And you think about what you'll be tomorrow. Because the truth of that, a lot of us never experience real hunger.
Right.
Do I have a witness here? But I need to understand this matter of discriminating needs to change. Maybe the Lord has allowed the covert virus to hit the United States of America so that we can have a different attitude.
Say
it. Understand you can't treat everybody the way you want to be treated. There's a connection between them and us.
Yeah.
Can I really believe somebody bought some stock in these companies that's going to make masks? Because they don't prevent, they were going to charge people $20 to get a mask.
Huh.
I think they bought stock in these companies that were going to have the tests.
Right.
They were going to charge $20 to $200 for the tests. Well, the Lord let a monkey wrench go in all of it. First of all, people didn't wait for them to send them a mask.
Right.
Folks like daddy start making their own masks. Y'all better hear me today. And so they couldn't sell their masks because folks making their own masks.
Yeah.
And then they going to go around here and this other problem, these people decided that we need to have a test. My question, okay, number one, do you have enough tests for everybody?
No.
I don't care how these numbers they throwing around, baby. It's not large enough for everybody in the United States of America. Y'all baby, what you talking about, man? You gonna be preaching. I am talking about the difference between God's laws and man's laws. Well, what is the problem? You got a problem with folk who are so busy looking out for themselves. vice president had it. We take a test every day.
Yeah.
Question. If poor people can't get a test, Brother Clint, why are they gonna be getting tests every day?
Well,
y'all better hear what I'm telling you. I keep telling y'all, they don't give a fat rat about you. All they concern is if we got enough tests for us, we gonna make it. We all right.
Right.
They ain't worried about no food. See, y'all. They tell you, you I ain't hungry. They got food. Well, you can go buy some food already. They don't have no problem with you going to Walmart and buy food.
Right.
But you can't go and get your hair did. Oh, y'all. He said, I'm still going to drink it. Y'all missed it. What he was trying to say is, the drink has so much power over him that even when the drinking will cost him his life, he's still going to drink it.
Yeah.
Y'all understand that. See, sin can have a way to control you.
Right.
Sin can have a way to overpower you that it causes you to do that which is contrary to your best interest.
Right.
Don't look at me like y'all know what I'm talking about. The doctor told you to stop eating sugar. You've been eating cake every week. Don't eat no pork chop. We all have some smothered pork chop. That we'll do stuff we know is diametrically opposed to our better health.
Right.
But you want to look cross-eyed at the alcoholic when in fact we're all in the same boat. Sin has a way of messing with you.
Well, he said,
Ezekiel one came out with it first. Jeremiah talked about it. The fathers eat sour grapes, and the children end up with some rotten teeth. Yeah, that teeth, that ain't fair. Why would God suffer and punish a child for what his daddy did?
Huh.
Well, you keep reading, the same Bible tells you that the child won't suffer for the parent.
Right.
He said the soul that sinned, come on here somebody, that's the one that's going to die.
Hmm.
When I found out, when a child keeps seeing his daddy messing up, is there something his nature wants causes him to want to be just like that?
Amen.
His daddy's acting a fool, he won't act a fool.
Yeah.
His daddy knocked the mess out of his mama, he thinks you don't love somebody unless you're knocking the mess out of him. That there's this tendency to want to do what you see daddy doing. So they're not dying because of what daddy did. They're dying because they're duplicating. Come on here, son. What daddy did. That this matter of the law condemning us is not condemning us for Adam. It's condemning us for us.
Yeah.
We decide we want to go our own way and do our own thing and live our own life. And we decide we want to do what we want to do. Well, you got to understand there are consequences to those kinds of actions.
Yeah.
Sin will mess you up. Sin will destroy you. And Paul in this same book says the wages of sin is death.
Yeah.
Well, not only do I see this real relationship, I got a real relationship between me and God. I got a real relationship between me and Adam. I got a real relationship between Marginale and myself. I got a real relationship between Felix and myself. Well, that's true, but there are consequences not because of what Marginale told me. There are consequences to what I do, that I can be raised in a bad situation and still turn out to be a child of God.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Well, I also see we have a righteous remedy.
Yeah.
So that since sin kills us, he says, one man fixed it all.
Yeah.
God then had to save man himself. And so when he did, he wraps himself up in human flesh.
Man.
Just like man.
Yeah.
And yet he passed the test. Well, I said, well, don't be tripping because one man messed you up. Because just like one man messed you up, one man also fixed you up.
Amen.
That Jesus is the one who gives us access to God.
Right.
Jesus is the one who pays the price that we could not pay for ourselves. Jesus is the one who enables us to conquer this criminality nature that is embedded in us.
Yeah,
alcohol can control you unless you got some Holy Ghost in you. Once the Spirit of God is born in you, then you have something that can overpower said we are slaves to sin.
Yeah.
I wish I had a witness here. You know what a slave is? A slave means that sin tells you what to do. And you have to do what your master told you to do. But then Paul didn't stop there. He says, I'm a slave to sin, but I also died to sin. I wish I had a witness here. I don't care how strong your master is, it's hard to make a dead man move. If you don't believe me, next time y'all get open and y'all go to a funeral home, you walk up to the casket and you tell that man or woman in that casket, get up and see how much they move. Get on out of there. Stop acting like you crazy. Get out of that casket. You can talk till the cows come home. They ain't going to move. And by the way, if they do move, you're going to try to move faster. I wish I had a bit. Yeah. When you're dead, dead folk don't take orders from anybody.
Yeah.
Paul said, I died to sin so that the sin kept trying to order me around. But I was liberated by the power of the Holy Spirit. Yeah. So we have a twofold inheritance. Yes, I inherited a sinful nature. But he said, well, guess what? I also inherited a righteous nature.
Amen.
I inherited in a messed up nature, but I also inherited something that was good.
Yeah.
Y'all don't hear me? Well, my brothers and sisters, let me close by talking about the resulting refinement. You see, Paul said that the law has consequences.
Yeah.
And the law abounds. That when you break the law, you got to mess up. You're going to get messed up. You will be messed up. You have to pay the consequences. And the wages of sin, the consequences of sin, is that you got to die.
Yeah.
Yes, but he says the law abounds, but then, grace even much more abounds.
Right.
Oh, thank God for grace.
Amen.
The grace of God allows me to overcome my birth condition.
Mm-hmm.
The great birth of Christ, the grace of God enables me to overcome my evil nature.
Right.
The grace of Christ that I'm justified. Justified don't mean that God forgave you for your sin. Wish I had a witness here. But that God cleaned the record.
Right.
Yeah.
You are justified. You are no longer guilty of sin because Jesus paid it all.
Yeah.
And all to him I owe. Right. Why did he do it? He did it because of God's grace. God's God giving us our unmerited, his unmerited favor. That God not only forgave my sin, but he gives me blessings that's beyond what I could even hope or expect.
Amen.
Do I have a witness here?
Yeah.
The resulting refinement, the resulting situation is that me and God are in good relationship.
Yeah.
The resulting result is that the Holy Spirit lives with me. That I've got a companion. I'm back to where I was in Eden. He threw me out of Eden. He separated me from himself. But when Jesus died, I'm back in right relationship with God. And he can live with me. He can walk with me. He can talk with me. In fact, I have him inside of me. He was born inside of me. There is a connection. But you see, there's a twofold relationship. We got a twofold inheritance, but there is a difference between my sin nature and my grace nature.
Amen.
My sin nature is just a matter of succession. You see, I didn't ask nobody to look like Felix. That's just a matter of fact that because he's my daddy and Marjorie is my mama, there are certain traits I took on that a certain DNA I possessed. That was, they didn't ask me. I wasn't allowed to vote on it. When I got here, I can't go to court and change it. I can't ask the judge to order a law that's going to make me different. I can try like my poor boy Michael. I can go to the doctor and make some alterations. But when you get through, you still going to be the same you. Or you can cut your nose off. But when you have a baby, they ain't going to have your new nose. They're going to inherit that nose you were born with. That's part of your very essence. gonna have a witness here.
Amen.
But when I talk about this righteous nature, this nature that I gained from Jesus, he says I got to make some choices in this matter. That just like I chose to walk away from God, I got to also choose to accept God in my life. I got to choose to accept him as a part of who I am. I got to choose to let the Lord be the master of my life.
Yeah, yeah.
All you folk think you're going to accidentally be a Christian, it don't happen by accident, baby. No, you have to consciously choose, I want to live the rest of my life with the Lord.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can't be voted in by the church. You can't even be voted in by your cronies. You can't be voted in by the fellas on the corner. No, no. Everybody can say you're a good person and you can still go and burn in hell.
Huh.
The only way you're going to get in, you have to choose to accept the gift of God through Jesus Christ's dying on the cross.
Yeah.
Do I have a witness here? Well, when I choose Jesus, I choose the right way.
Yeah.
When I choose Jesus, I take on a new nature. When I choose Jesus, I overcome my sin nature and I revert back to the nature I had when God first created me. Yes, I started behaving like God intended me to behave in the first place. You know, the origin of sin is a mystery. God didn't make sin. I don't know where it came from. When God made Adam, he didn't make it with a flaw. God made it. Come on here, somebody.
Yeah, yeah.
The Bible said when he got through, he said, it's good.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Nothing wrong with Adam. But between God making Adam and God allowing Adam to have access to the devil, Adam made the wrong choice.
Huh.
You see, you can't be a free moral agent without having some free moral choice.
Amen.
Come on here. If God made me without the ability to choose, I become a robot. But once I can choose, I have to be able to choose right and wrong.
Yeah, yeah.
Come on here, somebody. Satan had already messed up, and so Satan offered him wrong. And I think I ought to tell you that there are some people being offered wrong today.
Huh.
Yeah, some of y'all looking at me like you don't know what I'm talking about. You know exactly what I'm talking about. Life is not just choosing what's right. Yes, he'll also give you some choices that are wrong, that wrong for you and wrong for those around you. And he said, but if you choose the right way, you can have eternal and everlasting life. Everlasting life, eternal life, is not just life that's a long continuation, but it's also a life that is broad and wide and magnificent in its possibilities. That when I accept God's life, I accept God's potential. When I accept living with God, I accept expansion. I can be a better person. I can live above and beyond what I could imagine or dream. I can be all that God wanted me to be, that he can do exceedingly abundantly above all that we can imagine. Yes, give me one more minute and I'll be through, but I just want to kind of brag on the Lord's everlasting life.
Yeah.
I found out living with God is better than trying to live on your own. I found out God can make me happier than I can make myself happy. I found out that if I had more money, it doesn't mean I'm going to have more joy.
Yeah.
I can have more money and still be magnificent God. But you see, it's one thing to behold beauty, but it's something else to appreciate the beauty. I found out that you can be exposed to beautiful things, but still not appreciate the beauty. Have you ever woke up in the morning and seen as though you have a new sensitivity? You look out the window and see what you've been looking out for years. Yes, but for some reason, this morning, you just don't look the same. The leaves appear to be a little bit greener. Feels a little cooler. It seems like you got a sensitivity that you can appreciate what you're looking at. And then then you hear a little bird chirping. You've heard the chirping birds before, but you kind of ignoring them. You blacked it out. But all of a sudden, the little bird's chirping is more like a little bird singing. He's singing a song. See, my man, that little bird has a joy that's innate. He's celebrating just seeing another day. He's not celebrating because he won the lottery. He's not celebrating because he got a raise. He's not celebrating because he just bought a brand new car. He's celebrating because he sees another day that he never seen before. And he just wants to sing his little song. He's chirping out his little voice and singing to the best of his ability. That's what real living is. It's being able to wake up in the morning and appreciate the God we serve. It's being able to wake up in the morning and feeling health and strength and saying, thank you, Lord, for another day. Thank you, Lord, for having an ache in my shoulder. For some people, I can't even feel the pain. Thank you, Lord, for being able to walk. Thank you, Lord, for being able to talk. Thank you, Lord, for my little shack, because it keeps the rain off my head and the sun from cooking me. Thank you, Lord, for my little hoopty. For some people, have to walk everywhere they go. Thank you, Lord, for being able to walk. For some people, have to be pushed around in a wheelchair.
Change your day. It'll make you right. It'll make you walk right. Great.
Are you praying?